希腊的问题千疮百孔，欧洲财长们表示要一步一步的进行解决。正因为这个理由，原本预测希腊可能会获得的资助的决定，在上周三欧洲财长们经过12小时的热议，没有达成协议而不欢而散，希腊的命运抉择就再次被推迟到下个星期一。那么本周的经济观察，刚刚从欧洲参加国际货币会议返回纽约的环球资讯公司总裁纳维蒂女士就来告诉我们她此行在欧洲的所见所闻，以她对欧洲问题目前主要的核心所在进行的分析。
What you've seen over there, the situation must be terrible over there.
Well, it's not immediately tangible if you're there. It's not like it's obvious visually. But before I went to Europe, I went to the IMF meetings in Tokyo, and there we had a lot of behind-the-scenes discussions with policymakers and key decision makers, and you could see the disparity of interests and a certain helplessness, specifically when it comes to such issues as austerity.
Lately, there like nationwide, or should I say Eurozone-wide demonstration to protest for the government to cut even more spending. So such a political headwinds for those governments, can they reach a consensus to get their situation turn around in time quickly?
Well, it depends. For instance, in Greece, I think people have come to the conclusion that it's too dangerous to orchestrate or trying to orchestrate an orderly exit of Greece, which was still discussed a few months ago, but now it's considered as being too dangerous. Nobody knows what's going to happen. Nobody wants to take that risk. They want to give Greece more money to stay in, because Greece, you don't want to open that Pandora's box and set a precedent. It would be like a blueprint. You let Greece exit and then contagion may spread to Portugal and who knows where else, Ireland. Mm-hmm. So you want to keep the country in. It's costly, and you've seen just recently how there have been arguments about who pays for it, and the IMF said we don't want to contribute anymore because it's too expensive and Greece hasn't complied enough with reforms. But I think eventually the IMF will stand behind those common measures.
Mm-hmm. Nowadays, there's bad economic numbers even come up from Germany. So the German economy is being impacted by the dragging along of both countries or other countries, the problem. You are a German yourself. You just came back. So what did you see over there?
I do think Germany doesn't operate in a vacuum. It's a big exporting country. Obviously, the rest of Europe, the demand is going to decrease, so they have been trying to diversify risk by expanding more into Asian markets, but even there we're seeing signs of a slowdown. So I think inevitably at some point Germany will also see increasing weakness, and we're seeing this tendency of the weakness spreading more to the core countries.
We don't see a sign of any compromise from anybody within the foreseeable future. So how bad the situation will have to be in Europe before everybody just put their foot down, let's go for it?
Probably really bad, but Mario Draghi, the president of the ECB, has helped with a bond buying program that has taken a lot of pressure off the market and decreased the risk of default, so that was helpful. Nevertheless, we don't really see credible policy measures at this point just yet, and we'll have to see. I think the ECB is going to remain active. And the question is, the losses have already arisen. They're already there and they're growing. And the question is, who will pay for it?